What are the risk factors going to be?
Yeah, you know, genetics are 60 to 70% of it, but the modifiable risk factors, the things we can do about age, unfortunately we can't do anything about that. But
I'm getting in the age bracket.
So smoking is certainly one thing.
Smoking kills.
Yeah, it does.
So you've got to be able to stop. Mm-hmm. You've got good programs to stop smoking?
Yeah, we're getting better. Again, it comes down to patients wanting to quit. If they get to the point of wanting to quit, we've got a lot of things to help you, but you got to get to that point.
Other risk factors?
Other risk factors certainly are high blood pressure and diabetes.
We've got lots of good medicines for their diabetes. Right. You want to get the blood sugar down or your hemoglobin A1C down. Mm-hmm. If you don't, you got diabetes and you got big time troubles
right.
for that. So are we very effective in taking care of those risk factors?
Yeah, the diabetic medications have come a long way. Our cardiovascular medicines, it's still statin, and aspirin. But as long as we have people adhere to these things, we have pretty low rates of recurrence of coming back to the table after a heart attack, less than 5% at 5 years with a stent that you're coming back to see us again.
Obesity and sedentary lifestyle.
Right.
As part of the risk factors. Mm-hmm. You know, in our nation, we're getting more overweight and more overweight.
Mm-hmm.
And so if people start at an early age, is that that's something they can do to prevent the heart attacks mm-hmm. at an early age. What would be your overall summary? What would your advice be to people? You're young, you're thin, you eat well, I'm betting you exercise. What's your advice to the public? Because we're going downhill.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, the intake into your body is the most important thing, I think. And people try to lose weight or use an excuse of, I can't exercise, therefore I can't lose weight. But if you don't put it in your body, the weight gain won't happen. Exercise is a little more difficult. People think if they can't go out and exercise 2 hours at a time, then they're not doing their body any good. Not true. There's been a trial looking at no exercise to low to moderate intensity exercise. And actually, there's a benefit to 15 minutes a day or 90 minutes a week. There's still cardiovascular benefit. Less than that, probably not, but everybody can get into 15 minutes of moving around on some level a day, period.